Now let's take a quick look at two important structures on the dorsal aspect. We shall not focus on the individual muscles on the extensor aspect. Instead, we will focus first on this space here. This space that you see here is the anatomical snuffbox. So anatomical snuffbox has got a medial boundary and it's got a lateral boundary. And you can see them clearly here. The medial boundary is formed by the abductor pollicis longus and the extensor pollicis brevis. The abductor pollicis longus and the extensor pollicis brevis is forming the medial boundary, and the lateral boundary is formed by the extensor pollicis longus. The proximal end, you can feel the radial stellate process. Distally, we can feel the base of the first metacarpal bone, and on the floor, we can feel the trapezium. And as I already mentioned, running through the floor is this structure, the most important structure, that is the deep branch of the radial artery, which courses through and which continues into the palm as the deep palmar arch. Okay, that's the one thing which I wanted to show you. The next thing I wanted to show you are the tendons which are running on the dorsal aspect of the wrist, just like I showed you the tendons on the palmar aspect of the wrist. Can you see the structure here obliquely going up, this band of fibers? This is the extensor retinaculum. It is going obliquely from the radius to the ulnar side. And this, as it crosses over, it divides the whole dorsal aspect into six compartments. So let's take a quick look. The first compartment, we have the abductor pollicis longus and the extensor pollicis brevis. The second compartment gives passage to the extensor carpi radialis longus and extensor carpi radialis brevis. The third compartment gives passage to the extensor pollicis longus. The fourth compartment gives passage to these four tendons, the extensor digitorum and the extensor indicis. The fifth compartment gives passage to the extensor digiti minimi. And the sixth compartment gives passage to this portion that you see here, and that is the extensor carpi ulnaris. So these are the six compartments under the extensor retinaculum. Okay, having mentioned that, let's come to the last part. And that is, what are the structures that we can see on the palm, on the hand? This, because of this rigor mortis, this hand has been frozen. But anyway, let's see what we can salvage from here. What are the structures that we see on the hand? Straight away, we notice, first of all, that this was, as we had mentioned, this was the palmar ligament, the palmar tendon, the palmar's longest tendon. Palmar's longest tendon gets inserted onto the flexor retinaculum, also known as the transverse carpal ligament. And the flexor retinaculum is attached to the pisiform and the hook of hamate, lunate scaphoid, and the trapezium. So therefore, it forms a tunnel which is known as the carpal tunnel, and through that carpal tunnel travels the main trunk of the median nerve, which I mentioned. Attaching to the flexor retinaculum, we can see this structure here. This is the palmar aponeurosis. And the palmar aponeurosis, as you know, has got four slips, each slip going towards the middle little finger, the ring finger, the middle finger, and the index finger. So this is the palmar aponeurosis. What we can also see on the lateral side, we can see this elevated group of muscles. These are collectively the muscles of the thenar eminence. And on the ulnar side, we can see this group of muscles. These are collectively the muscles of the hypothenar eminence. And incidentally, a few slips of the palmaris brevis, which is superficial, it is not part of the hypothenar eminence, is also seen here. This is the palmaris brevis. What else we can see? We can see some of the fibers of the median nerve here. The metacarpal branches, and they will divide into the common and the proper digital branches. We can see one of the median nerve branches here. And there are a few other branches which are visible on the other sides also. I would like to draw your attention to this interosseous muscle here, which I already mentioned in the first interspace, that is between the metacarpal bone first and the second. And I also told you the significance of that is that there's a small tunnel there which gives passage to the deep branch of the radial artery, which goes from the dorsal aspect and comes to the palmar aspect and forms a deep palmar arch. So that's all for this dissection. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for watching. If you have any questions or comments, put them in the comment section below. Thank you, camera persons. Have a nice day.